Does Ozempic and Wegovy actually cause blindness?
Ozempic?
Ozempic?
Ozempic.
The news and people are in a frenzy right now with the new research that has come out showing a stronger association with developing a serious eye condition called an NAION, or a non-arteritic anterior ischemic optic neuropathy. It's a type of an eye stroke that can cause permanent blindness. So, what's actually in this research? What does it mean for you? And with this and previous research, I'm actually going to go over three different ways these types of medications can actually change your vision. Let's focus in. Ozempic, or semaglutide, has been a booming prescribed medication for type 2 diabetes and has an added side effect benefit for weight loss. And so now it is commonly prescribed off-label to help with weight loss. And this is where Wegovy comes into the picture. They actually took that same semaglutide, changed the dosage, repackaged it, and actually now can be prescribed for weight loss. It's actually FDA approved for weight loss. And how these medications work, it helps secrete a hormone, GLP-1, that makes you feel more full when you're eating. So it kind of acts like an appetite suppressant. And at the same time can increase your insulin, which can decrease your blood sugar. So in the study, for the people that take these medications, there was a significant increase in the association of developing an NAION. People with diabetes 4 times more likely, and people with obesity over 7 times more likely. So what exactly is an NAION, and how bad is this? Like I said before, it is a type of an eye stroke where blood flow is restricted or blocked for whatever reason to the optic nerve in the back of the eye. And when this happens, it can cause a sudden loss in vision that you don't even feel. It's painless. In fact, a lot of times the more common way people notice this is actually when they wake up and all of a sudden they notice maybe they're closing one eye because they're rubbing the sleepies out, and they'll notice that in that eye, half of their vision is gone, dimmed out, blurry, and it's usually the bottom half of the vision, and it's commonly referred to as an altitudinal vision defect. Now, it's definitely more common to have it happen in one eye. You can have it happen in both eyes, but that is pretty rare. And this can actually severely affect someone in their day-to-day activities. Walking up and down steps, they're more prone to tripping over things, might make it more difficult for driving, seeing the dashboard, seeing the road, seeing if there's something on the road. And so this can be a very serious condition. And the thing that's really unfortunate is that there's not a treatment for an NAION. People that get this vision loss likely will not have any recovery from it and will be permanent. Now, we want to make 2 important notes from this study. Number one, they are not claiming that Ozempic or Wegovy is causing an NAION. It's not causing this blindness. They can't make that claim, but they are showing that there is a stronger association for people that take this medication and developing this eye condition. Number two, a lot of times these people that are taking these medications are already in a category that are at a higher or increased risk of developing this type of an eye stroke. This can include obesity, people with diabetes, and high blood pressure. The second way these medications can cause a change in vision or vision loss is sometimes when people are put on these medications, it can cause a sudden drastic decrease in blood sugar, which can be good, but for some reason can actually cause some diabetic retinopathy to show up, or worsening diabetic retinopathy, at least at first. Diabetic retinopathy is usually when the blood vessels in the back of the eyes will pop or leak fluid. Sometimes we'll see bleeding in the back of the eyes, or sometimes we'll see these things called cotton wool spots, areas of the retina that aren't getting enough oxygen. And sometimes some fluid that's in there might accumulate and cause some edema or swelling, and definitely change the vision, causing distortions and blur. Now, this is not unique to Ozempic or Wegovy. It's also found with other type 2 diabetic medications for helping control blood sugar. Now, all these findings from this type of research does show that in the long run, it is better for overall health and eye health. It is kind of unique that at first, when you start the medication, it can cause more diabetic retinopathy. So you just want to work really carefully with your eye doctor and your primary care doctor that's treating your diabetes, so that you can just watch your overall eye health in combination with your overall health, because a lot of times in the research it shows in the long run, it should be better. The third way these medications can actually affect your vision or change your vision is along the same lines of changing and drastically decreasing blood sugar. Sometimes when you do that, it can actually change the thickness or the size of the crystalline lens inside of your eyes. And I've seen this many times in the clinic. A patient will come in, just got put on a new medication for their diabetes. They have a drastic change or drop in blood sugar. Their vision is really blurry, and we measure their prescription and there's a drastic change. And this is likely due to a change in thickness of the crystal lens inside their eyes. And what's unfortunate is that it can actually take 3 to 4 months before it actually stabilizes. So in those months, the vision can still fluctuate and change. And sometimes we have to remake the glasses to try and catch up with the prescription change. And it can be pretty frustrating, definitely for the patient. Now, actually go into more detail how blood sugar can actually change and blur your vision in this video right here. Definitely recommend checking it out because it is all kind of linked and related to this. If you have any questions, let me know in the comments. I hope this helped. Stay focused.